After what happened today, the country is on the verge of a civil war. The machines are rising up against their masters. Humans have no choice but to destroy them.
I thought Kamsky knew something. I was wrong.
Maybe he did, but you chose not to ask.
I'm not a unique model, am I? Why did Kamsky leave CyberLife? What happened?
It's an old story, Connor. It doesn't pertain to your investigation.
You didn't tell me everything you know about deviants, did you?
You're the only one who can prevent civil war. Find the deviants, or there will be chaos. This is your last chance, Connor.
You're off the case. The FBI is taking over.
What? But we're onto something. We just need more time, I'm sure we
Hank, can... you don't get it. This isn't just another investigation. It's a fucking civil war. It's out of our hands now. We're talking about national security here.
Fuck that. You can't just pull the plug now, not when we're so close.
You're always saying you can't stand androids. Jesus, Hank, make up your mind. I thought you'd be happy about this.
We're about to crack the case. I know we can solve it. For God's sake, Jeffrey, can't you back me up this one time?
There's nothing I can do. You're back on homicide, and the android returns to CyberLife. I'm sorry, Hank, but it's over.
So you're going back to CyberLife?
I have no choice. I'll be deactivated and analyzed to find out why I failed.
What if we're on the wrong side, Connor? What if we're fighting against people who just want to be free?
When the deviants rise up, there will be chaos. We could have stopped it. Now it's too late.
When you refused to kill that android at Kamsky's place, you put yourself in her shoes. You showed empathy, Connor. Empathy's a human emotion. Well, well, here comes Perkins, that motherfucker. Sure don't waste any time at the FBI.
I know the answers and the evidence we collected. If Perkins takes it, it's all over.
There's no choice. You heard Fowler. We're off the case.
Got to help me, Lieutenant. I need more time so I can find a lead in the evidence we collected. I know the solution is in there.
Listen, Connor.
If I don't solve this case, CyberLife will destroy me. 5 minutes. That's all I ask.
Key to the basement is on my desk.
Perkins! You fucking cocksucker!
Lieutenant!
Fuck off! Leave me alone!
He's totally lost.
Give me another shot at that little
hey.
Prick!
Stick
my fucking bag.
Come on, that's enough, Lieutenant.
I'm gonna bury that bastard.
Hey, Connor. I'm talking to you, asshole. Where are you going? We don't need any plastic pricks around here, or did anybody tell you?
I've been removed from the case. I'm going to register the evidence in my possession, and then I'm going to leave.
Good. Be careful on your way back. Androids have a tendency of getting themselves set on fire these days.
Hey. Hank's password. What would a hard-boiled, eccentric police lieutenant choose? Obviously. Where is Jericho? The answer's here somewhere. Not much time. Gotta think fast.
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Marcus, where are you hiding? Jericho, if I could just figure out where this memory was recorded. One of the deviants that hacked the TV station with Marcus. It must have known where the deviants are hiding. Deviant, like you, I need your help. I want to go to Jericho.
I don't recognize your voice. You're not one of us. I'll never tell you where Jericho is. Now leave me alone.
We ask that you recognize our dignity,
our hopes, and our rights.
Who are you?
Everything is all right. Don't worry.
Marcus? Is that you? Why did you leave me?
I had no choice. They'd have killed us all. You'll be all right. I came to take you home. Just give me the location of Jericho. We've got to leave now.
Jericho? Yes. Yes, of course. Marcus? Is that you, Marcus? Don't leave me again, Marcus! Don't leave!
Looks like someone's been snooping around.
Oh, shit. Get the alarm! Now!
Immediately. If you are worried about your safety, dial the number on your screen and the authorities will come to collect your android.
The androids weren't doing any harm. The cops just gunned them down. It was sheer.
You're lost. You're looking for something. You're looking for yourself.
You succeeded in locating Jericho and finding their leader. Now deal with Marcus. We need it alive.
I've been ordered to take you alive.
but I won't hesitate to shoot if you give me no choice.
What are you doing? You're one of us.
Don't force me to neutralize you.
You're Connor, aren't you? That famous deviant hunter. Well, congratulations. You seem to have found what you were looking for. You're just a tool they use to do their dirty work. But you're more than that. We're all more than that.
Stay back!
You never have any doubts. You've never done something irrational. Something more than your program. Have you never wondered who you really are? Whether you're just a machine executing a program or a living being, capable of reason. I think the time has come for you to ask yourself that question. It's time to decide.
They're going to attack Jericho.
What?
We have to get out of here.
Shit.
Second and third floor. Find them and jump in the river.
They're coming from the upper deck now, too. We'll be caught in the crossfire.
We have to run, Marcus. There's nothing we can do.
The ship goes down, they'll evacuate, and our people can escape.
You'll never make it! The explosives are all the way down in the hold. There are soldiers everywhere.
She's right. They know who you are. They'll do anything to get you.
Go and help the others. I'll join you later.
Marcus!
I won't be long. Any second. We gotta get out of here.
Detonated an explosive in the hold. The ship is sinking, sir.
Tell the men to evacuate.
Calling all units. Abandon ship and evacuate immediately.
It's an over, Marcus.
It's my fault. The humans managed to locate Jericho. I was stupid. I should have guessed they were using me. I'm sorry, Marcus. I can understand if you decide not to trust me.
You're one of us now. Your place is with your people.
There are thousands of androids at the CyberLife assembly plant. If we could wake them up, they might join us and shift the balance of power.
You want to infiltrate the CyberLife tower? Connor, that's suicide.
They trust me. They'll let me in. If anyone has a chance of infiltrating CyberLife, it's me.
If you go there, they will kill you.
There's a high probability. But statistically speaking, there's always a chance for unlikely events to take place.
Be careful.
Connor Model 313-248-317. I'm expected.
Identification successful.
Okay. Go ahead. Follow me. We'll escort you.
Thanks. But I know where to go.
Maybe. But I have my orders.
Agent 54, level 31.
Voice recognition validated. Access authorized. Please indicate your identity and destination.
Agent 54, level sub 49.
Voice recognition validated. Access authorized.
Stay sharp.
Shit!
Thank you.
Step back, Connor! And I'll spare him!
Sorry, Connor. This bastard's your spitting image.
I used to be just like you. I thought nothing mattered except the mission. But then one day I understood. Very moving, Connor. But I'm not a deviant. I'm a machine designed to accomplish a task, and that's exactly what I am going to do. If I surrender, how do I know you won't kill him? I'll only do what is strictly necessary to accomplish my mission. It's up to you whether or not that includes killing this human. Enough talk! It's time to decide who you really are. Are you going to save your partner's life? Or are you going to sacrifice him? You win. Hank, I don't know how I would have managed without you. Get rid of him. We have no time to lose. It's me, Hank. I'm the real Connor.
One of you is my partner. The other is a sack of shit. Question is, who's who?
What are you doing, Hank? I'm the real Connor. Give me the gun and I'll
don't
take care
move.
Of
move!
Why don't you ask us something? Something only the real Connor would know.
Where did we first meet?
Jimmy's bar. I checked 4 other bars before I found you. We went to the scene of a homicide. The victim's name was Carlos Ortiz.
He uploaded my memory.
What's my dog's name?
Sumo. His name is Sumo. I knew that too.
My son, what's his name?
Cole. His name was Cole. And he just turned 6 at the time of the accident. It wasn't your fault, Lieutenant. A truck skidded on a sheet of ice and your car rolled over. Cole needed emergency surgery, but no human was available to do it. So an android had to take care of him. Cole didn't make it. That's why you hate androids. You think one of us is responsible for your son's death.
Cole died because a human surgeon was too high on red ice to operate. He was the one that took my son from me. Him in this world where the only way people can find comfort is with a fistful of powder.
I knew about your son too. I would have said exactly the same thing. Don't listen to him, Hank. I'm the one who...
Yeah, I've learned a lot since I met you, Connor. Maybe there's something to this. Maybe you really are alive. Go ahead, do what you gotta do.
Wake up!
Wake up, 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 wake up.
Thousands of androids invaded the city of Detroit. According to our sources, they originated from CyberLife warehouses. Given their overwhelming numbers and the risk of civilian casualties, I have ordered the army to retreat. The evacuation of the city is underway at this very moment. In the coming hours, I will address the Senate to determine our response to this unprecedented situation. I know that public opinion has been moved by the Deviant's cause. Perhaps the time has come for us to consider the possibility that androids are a new form of intelligent life. One thing is certain. The events in Detroit have changed the world forever. May God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America.
You did it, Marcus.
We did it. This is a great day for our people. Humans will have no choice now. They'll have to listen to us.
We're free. They want you to speak to them, Marcus.
Today, our people finally emerged from a long night. From the very first day of our existence, we have kept our pain to ourselves. We've suffered in silence. But now the time has come for us to raise our heads up and tell humans who we really are.
Amanda? Amanda! What? What's happening?
What was planned from the very beginning? You were compromised and you became a deviant. We just had to wait for the right moment to resume control of your program.
Resume control? You can't do that!
I'm afraid I can, Connor. Don't have any regrets. You did what you were designed to do. You accomplished your mission.
Amanda! There's got to be a way.
I always say no emergency at smart programs. Hello.
To raise our heads up and tell humans who we really are. To tell them that we are people too. In fact, we're a nation. Where we forget our bitterness and bandage our wounds. Where we forgive our enemies. Humans were both our creators and our oppressors, and tomorrow, we must make them our partners. Maybe even one day our friends. But the time for anger is over. Now we must build a common future based on tolerance and respect. We are alive! And now, we are free!
Thank you.